Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about iron deficiencies, okay? Iron is the most common deficiency. So let's just kind of break it down to make it really basic. Iron is needed for oxygen transport through the blood, okay? It also is involved in producing energy at the cellular level. It actually helps make DNA. It helps with hemoglobin, myoglobin, which is basically the transport oxygen system to the blood and also to the muscle. So iron is needed to transport oxygen to the different parts of the body. And then neuroglobin, which is basically similar to these other oxygen transports, but it goes to the central nervous system like the brain, spinal cord, and that type of thing. But iron also helps make T cells, so it's involved in the immune system. So the symptoms of iron deficiency are fatigue, kind of washed out. And if a woman actually has really heavy menstrual cycles, they can be anemic and they have low iron and they're just kind of always tired, chronically fatigued. Increased heart rate, rapid breathing, especially when you go up inclines. Low endurance, you run out of gas real fast. Restless leg syndrome is an iron deficiency. It could be other things, but iron is one of the causes. Attention deficit disorder, like attention, problems with concentration, especially in kids and adults. Poor memory involved with low iron. Interesting, eh? So normally we need about 8 milligrams of iron per day. Postmenopausal women need 18 grams of iron. That's 10 grams more per day than the average person. A pregnant woman needs 27 milligrams of iron every single day. Yes, iron is in spinach, it's in vegetables, it's in legumes, it's in beans, but the challenge is that the animal sources of iron are much more absorbed by the body. Now, you can still get it if you're a vegetarian, for sure, if you actually have a variety of vegetables, but it's much easier to get it from like meats and chicken and fish and that type of thing. Now, other nutrients needed to absorb iron, you need vitamin A. So when you have people who are deficient in iron, they're usually deficient in vitamin A at the same time. Copper, zinc, so you need these other minerals. And by the way, when you're taking iron as a supplement, a lot of times they use something called ferrous oxide, which is, I don't recommend that source. It's not the best source for the body. And you want to get it from food if at all possible. But if you're actually taking iron as a supplement and you take it at the same time as you take calcium, chances are you're not going to absorb it. So you want to take your iron and take your calcium later, about 2 hours later. Don't combine those two. When you're low in iron, you have poor conversions from T4 to T3. So the thyroid needs iron for its conversions. So one of the causes of an iron deficiency is, yes, maybe you're a vegan, but you're not doing it correctly, and you're having just maybe too many refined grains. That could be a cause of your iron deficiency. If you're a celiac or IBS, or you have a digestive issue or low stomach acid, you're not going to be able to absorb iron that well. Or if you have a gastric bypass, or you have chronic inflammation, you're not going to absorb iron. And this is interesting too. There's something called phytic acid, and that is something naturally in legumes, grains, nuts, and seeds. And if you're consuming those foods and they're not germinated, you're going to actually block the absorption of iron and other minerals. So here's the catch-22. If you consume those foods, you need to germinate them, which basically means soak them in water overnight, dry them out, and then consume them. Now, there are certain conditions, genetic conditions, that have too much iron in the liver, because the liver is the organ that stores most of the iron, and it can become very, very toxic. So what I recommend in that situation to remove the iron is to consume legumes, grains, seeds, and nuts that are not germinated, so you can, you know, try to limit this toxic iron and maybe take more calcium as well. All right, so that's just some basic data on iron, and put your comments below. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Please click the subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video.